Today we are visiting the mountainous microstate surrounded entirely by Italy, the Republic of San Marino. Andiamo! From the Italian beachside town of Rimini, you can take a tourist bus to visit San Marino. The Republic is the third smallest country in Europe. Landlocked, it's located on the border between the Italian regions of Emilia-Romagna and Marche. With a territorial extension of 61.19 kilometers squared, populated by 33,909 inhabitants, it's one of the least populous among the member states of the Council of Europe and the United Nations. Since 2008, the historic center of the city of San Marino and Mount Titano have been included by UNESCO among the heritages of humanity as testimony of the continuity of a free republic since the 13th century. The fountain within the garden was a gift by the American people for the inauguration of the new aqueduct on the 31st of May, 1962. It bears the symbol of the Serenissima Republic of San Marino, the three towers, and above the word for Libertas, which is the motto of the Republic. The Cava dei Balestrieri is a real quarry, created from the end of the 1800s to collect the materials necessary for the restoration of the Palazzo Pubblico, a symbol of the city and republican power. Today, the site's used for sports activities related to shooting with the Italian crossbow, a sport widely practiced in the ancient republic. Within the old towns is a cable car that connects the lower Borgo Maggiore to the historic center. Lasting about 2 minutes, the journey will allow you to admire over 200 kilometers of the Adriatic coast. Piazza della Libertà is the main square of San Marino, and it hosts the public palace and numerous other places of historical and architectural interest on one side of the square, while on the other, it's completely open, allowing a view over the entire landscape of the Montefeltro. The Basilica is the main place of Catholic worship in the city of San Marino, belonging to the Diocese of San Marino Montefeltro. It is dedicated to the patron saint of the city and the state. The Basilica is also depicted on San Marino 10-cent euro coins. Upper San Marino has three fortified towers built around the 14th century, with expansions from the 16th. The Rocca Guaita, erected in the 11th century, houses a chapel erected in honor of Santa Barbara, while the Rocca Sesta, the second tower, was built in the 13th century on the highest point of the mountain, which includes a castle with a museum of weapons and a small church that precedes the third and smallest of the three towers, the Montale. Paso de la Strega is a path carved in stone between the first and the second tower. While it offers a magnificent view from above over the whole valley dominated by the mountain, it has a legend attached to it. Its name is due to the height and whistling of the wind. It's said that in the Middle Ages, witches gathered here to practice their magic rituals, singing and dancing around the fire. Between myths and ancient narratives, the legend is associated with black cats that were killed during the medieval era, as they were claimed to have embodied the soul of witches, intent on stealing and kidnapping the bodies of young girls they met on their way. Even today, along the path, many swear to hear them laugh and joke, especially on summer nights. On your way back to the train station in Rimini, it might be an idea to stop by the beach to enjoy some sun and sand along the Adriatic. Well, I hope you all enjoyed this little visit to the Republic of San Marino, a must visit on your next adventure in Italy. Until next time, alla prossima! Did you enjoy this episode? Please hit the like button and subscribe to be in the know for future episodes.